Airtable is a very powerful tool for project management. But you might be getting a little stuck when it comes to your relative dates. If a task is dependent on something else in order to be completed, how does everything change and get updated if something's pushed off track? There can be downstream implications for missing a due date, and in this video, we're going to be talking about how you can set up your dates to function in a relative way so that they automatically update as things change. So if this is of interest to you, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting, and it's our mission to help you to get organized and automated with no-code tools. Airtable is one of our favorite no-code tools, and in this video, we're going to be jumping into relative dates so that you can keep things up to date, no pun intended, in your database, no matter what happens as things change. But before we hop into it, first I want to invite you to join me for my free Airtable crash course. This crash course is going to teach you the basics of Airtable so that you can get up and running, even if you don't fully understand how to build your first relational database just yet. Grab that crash course at gapconsulting.io/airtable-crash-course. I'll include links wherever you found this video. But for now, let's hop on into the heart of things and take a look at how we can start working with relative dates inside of our Airtable setup. Hopping on into my screen here, you'll see that I have a pretty simple database setup. Two tables, projects, and tasks. We're gonna be doing the majority of our work inside of the tasks, but projects, just at a high level, are gonna contain your project level data, and of course this will link over to your tasks table. Over here in my second table, this is where all the magic is gonna happen. So you can see right now I've created three different tasks, I've assigned them to myself, and they are connected back to the project. So I've got project one here with three tasks, and now for the part where things get a little bit complicated, I'm building a dependency. I am saying, look, this task right here, task two, depends on task one to be complete first. Task one is going to allow us to do task two. Task three, similarly, is going to be requiring that task two is first completed. So I've built this dependency by linking here from my table tasks to my table tasks. So I'm linking, self-linking within the same table. I'm simply saying this tasks table links to itself, and this allows me to establish my dependencies inside of the different tasks associated within a project. So here we have our due date. Now right now, I only have one of these due dates filled out. So I'm saying that task one is going to be due on 8/21. Maybe this inherits the start date of a project. Maybe when the project is first created, I know that the first task, based on our rules within our template or our automations, is going to be set out for a certain number of days. Whatever the case may be, I'm assuming that I have my first due date of my tasks. Now I'm also able to use a rollup field to look at my different dependencies and figure out which of their due dates is the biggest. So understand here that maybe a task can link to multiple dependencies. Maybe, for example, task three depends on task one and task two. I could simply make that selection here, expand that a little bit, and we now see tasks one and task two are being evaluated here. So the question becomes, well, which of the due dates do I care about? If task one has its own due date and task two has its own due date, which due date do I care about? And the answer, of course, is I care about the bigger one. So that's why I'm using a rollup field here. This rollup field is looking at that dependency relationship, it's looking at the due date, and it's looking at the maximum of the different due dates available. So now on my third task here, that is the third row that's dependent on tasks one and two, it will always inherit the largest due date available between task one and task two. Okay, now I have my days to complete over here. Now this is just a number field. I could fill this out with whatever I want. The important takeaway is that the days to complete is unique to the task. So day one, maybe that's a really long task. It could be 5 days. Task two might be a short one. Maybe it's a 1 day task to complete. And then this last one over here, maybe it's 7 business days. Note I said business days because over here, we're getting to our last date field. And this one is saying, Okay, under the conditions where I have a due date of my dependency, and this is really just allowing us to miss any errors, I'll get to that in a minute, but the magic is happening here. If I have the due date, then I want to take that due date and add to it the number of days to complete. So, seems pretty straightforward. Let's walk through it one step at a time so that this makes sense. Because if this part doesn't make sense, then the automation part is going to be too cumbersome to understand. So right now, I have my first task. It is due on August 21st. It takes 5 days to complete this task, and I should be able to calculate a due date. Well, I can't calculate a due date here because, number one, I already have a due date, but also there are no dependencies for task one. This is the first thing in a series of dominoes. This is number one domino. So in this case, I'm not able to calculate the due date here. But let's take a look at the next one. Here is task two. I have a due date of a dependency of 821. Why? Well, task two depends on task one. So we have this dependency right here. So I'm looking at all the different due dates that this could be dependent upon, and I'm taking the maximum of those. If you recall, that's why we used a roll-up field with the max values. Next, I'm saying this task takes 1 day to complete. So I know that the previous task is going to be done on or before August 21st. I know that this task, task two, will take 1 day to complete, so I can do the math, add 1 day to 821, so that this is now going to be due on August 22nd. Now, similarly, check this third task out. This task has two things that it's dependent upon, task one and task two. Well, only task one currently has a due date. So the max value of the due dates that this is dependent upon, this one is zero because task three is dependent on task two, but I don't have a date here. So I'm able to bring back the maximum date of 821. Now I'm able to say, okay, well, if that's when this last due date is going to be due in terms of the dependencies, well, I can add 7 days to this. But not just 7 days, 7 working days, 7 business days, excluding weekends. We get there, by the way, by using the workday formula. This takes into account only the work days and excludes any weekends or holidays. So 7 business days added to 821 is 830, August 30th. And that is when this one is calculated to be due. But that's not quite good enough. So we've got these calculations working, but what I really want are these calculations over here showing up in my due date. So how do I do that? Well, a pretty simple automation. I can go into my automation and simply say, when that calculated due date field is changed, in order to get that functionality, I set up a trigger that says, when the record is updated, and specifically, all I care about is this one field. So when this field is changed, that means we've calculated a new date. Well, when that happens, then I want to update that record. And I want to take that calculated due date, and I want to plug it into the due date field. That might be a little complex if this is the first automation you've built, but go one step at a time through the process and simply realize that all we're doing is saying, if that date gets updated in my calculation, then I'm going to take the calculated output and plug it into my due date. Now, when I turn this on, all the magic is going to happen. Let's flip back now into this, and I am going to trigger this automation. I will first remove my due date here, thereby wiping everything out, and now I'm going to plug that due date back in, 8:21, and watch as the automations do the thinking for me on the back end. So you can see here that we have some numbers fluctuating. And the first thing I want to point out is these numbers don't quite match up yet because Airtable is taking some time to calculate on the back end. So let's think about what this is doing. Remember that this due date right here, 8:21, is my due date of my dependency. So for task two, it relies on this one to be complete on 8:21. We take 8:21 and we add one date and we calculate 8:22. That number then gets updated and brought in right over here on my due date, which is again, just a date field. Now, for the next part, once this number is plugged in here, well, then you'll notice that our due date of dependency is updated because task three is looking at both task one and task two. And so it's looking at both of these numbers right here and picking the bigger of them for this output. Then we're gonna add 7 business days. So we're calculating August 31st. Once that number gets updated, our automation picks it up and plugs it into our due date. So this way, I can at any point in time update a due date. It would be fine enough to just stop with my calculated output here, but I want this to be a flexible date that I can actually manipulate. Maybe I need to bias a little bit of extra time for task 2. If I do that, I need the downstream effects to also properly get reflected here. So if I have to bias, let's say, 2 more days for this second task, I can update this to 8/24. This is something I could not do with the calculated field. As soon as I update it though, you see that this calculated due date for task 3 also gets updated, which means my automation is gonna wake up in just a second and say, hold on, there's a new number over here in my calculated due date. I better update right here as well. So that, my friend, is exactly how you can use some calculated due dates and make them relative to the other things that are happening inside of your different tasks and calculations. By using a calculated output and then updating it with an automation, you're able to get the best of both worlds. I know we went pretty fast in this video, so be sure to drop any questions you have below. And in the meantime, keep on building.